In this section, we'll look at the conditional statements in C#, which are used to execute different code blocks based on different conditions. The if statement will execute only if the expression inside the parentheses is validated to true. It can include any of the comparison and logical operators. To test for other conditions, we can extend the if statement with any number of else-if clauses. Each additional condition will only be tested if all previous conditions are false. The if statement can also have one else clause at end, which will execute if all previous conditions are false. As for the curly brackets, they can be left out if we only need to execute a single statement conditionally. Next, we have the switch statement, which checks for equality between either an integer or a string and a series of case labels, and then passes execution to the matching case. It may contain any number of case clauses, and it can end with a default label for handling all other cases. Note that the statement after each case label ends with a break keyword to break out of the switch. Unlike many other languages, the cases in C# must end with a jump statement, such as break. This means that we cannot leave out the break keyword to allow the execution to fall through to the next label. The reason for this is because unintentional fall-throughs is a common programming error. If we actually want to fall through, we have to explicitly show this using the go-to jump statement followed by a label, which will cause the execution to jump to that label. Go-to can also be used outside of the switch, but it's strongly discouraged since it can quickly become difficult to follow the flow of execution. In addition to the if and switch statements, there's the ternary operator that can replace a single else-if clause when it assigns values to a specific variable. This operator takes three expressions. If the first one is evaluated to true, the second expression is returned, and if it's false, the third one is returned.